Welcome to Some Assembly Required, Telescope Setup, Part 3. Let's continue to set up the telescope assembly by attaching the hand controller. Very simple process, two thumb screws and throw it in the cradle. The hand controller is used for star alignment and has a large database of targets. Next, we'll install the dew heater band. The dew heater band is made of Velcro and you simply wrap it around the telescope. Place the dew heater directly around the lens of the telescope. Use your finger on the outside and look down the front of the telescope to position on the dew shield. The idea is to warm the lens and prevent dew. Here's a little trick I use to conserve power. I use an indoor-outdoor thermometer with a wired probe. Place the wired probe under the dew heater band and mount the temperature gauge with Velcro to your mount. Here you can monitor the temperature of your scope and the outside temperature. This model has a handy humidity gauge too. Keep the scope temperature 10 degrees warmer than the outside temperature and you'll eliminate your dew problems. Another trick is to wrap an ACE bandage around the dew heater. This will help keep the heat from escaping in the cold night air. Try to find ACE bandages with Velcro. They're simpler to use. Next, I'll connect the power for the moonlight focuser. You'll notice I'm using paper towels for dust caps on my battery outlets. Using straight extension tubes are better than 90 degree diagonals. Anytime you make your light path reflect, you'll lose some of your precious imaging data. When you first start, you'll need to play around to find your focus point. And once you find your focus point, make a little sticker like I did. So the next time you're out, you'll have the focus point ready to go. Of course, this is a rough focus point, but it will be close enough to balance your telescope. I've tried tightening the extension thumb screws by hand, and I've seen them come loose during the night. Remember, any slack in your imaging train will produce poor results. I take my multi-tool and apply a light extra twist to each thumb screw. In part 4, we'll attach the CCD camera, filter wheel, balance the scope, and attach the autoguider scope. Thanks for watching and please subscribe.